I have painstakingly been through the newly published TENT A3 controlled clinical trial by Neuromod with a fine tooth comb so that you don't have to. And whilst there is a ton of positive, compelling evidence demonstrating why Lenire received FDA de novo approval for it to be used as a tinnitus treatment, I have three big suggestions on how I think that they can improve their credibility even further. How do you know if you're suffering with tinnitus right now? I ask this because for some people it's pretty subtle and for others it's obvious and inescapable. In its most basic form, tinnitus is the perception of a sound in either one or both of your ears, and it can even come from somewhere within your head, and it's not being produced by a sound source in the environment around you. Tinnitus is incredibly common, affecting around 10 to 15% of the US population alone, which is almost 50 million people. And of that 50 million, between 6 to 11% report significant discomfort. So it's no wonder that there are dozens, if not hundreds, of nonsensical tinnitus treatments out there for those of you that are desperate for a solution. In fact, in a recent poll that I put out there on YouTube, there was a real mix of things that you, my faithful YouTube community, have tried to overcome your tinnitus. Now, my videos get way more interaction than my polls, so I'm keen on knowing about your personal experiences. What have you tried to overcome your tinnitus? Perhaps hearing aids, mindfulness or CBT, maybe sound therapy and masking sounds, or even supplements or medicines from your doctor. Let me know in the comments because I'm curious to know what you've tried and if it's been successful. I'm aware that whilst this kind of conversation and evidence is anecdotal, there may just be somebody out there that reads your comments and gets some respite from their tinnitus based on your specific advice. So, now for the main reason that we're here today. I'm mainly here to share the finalized clinical evidence from Neuromod's scientific paper, the TENT A3 study, which led to Lenire's FDA approval in March 2023 and is now publicly available. For those of you out there just starting your research on tinnitus treatment technology, it makes sense for me to briefly run through what Lenire is and the unique way in which it works. You see, Lenire is the first of its kind that uses an innovative approach with a treatment called bimodal neuromodulation, in which a sound is presented to your ears in combination with gentle pulses which, believe it or not, are delivered via a mouthpiece that sits on your tongue. This makes it the first treatment of its kind to utilize the unique anatomy of the tongue and its rich network of nerves to provide you with relief from your tinnitus. Now, sound enrichment therapy itself is nothing new, but combining it with a mild electrical stimulation to the tongue has never been considered in the past. Of course, the first question that comes to my mind is why the tongue and why not another part of the body? Well, it isn't just by chance that they've chosen this part of your anatomy. Your tongue is densely packed with nerves, and as you can imagine, with many of them being in close proximity to the auditory pathways in the brain. So today I promised you a simple breakdown of Neuromod's latest research, the TENT A3 study, and I've broken down this study into three key areas, so three key areas of benefit ultimately. Firstly, I'm going to start off by talking about the effectiveness of this treatment for reducing your tinnitus. Ultimately, that's why you're all here. As you may well be aware, or you may well appreciate, achieving de novo FDA approval isn't a walk in the park, as what it essentially means is that you're developing an entirely new treatment in uncharted medical territory. So it's a way bigger deal than I'd initially ever been aware of. And therefore, what colours with that is the FDA wanting to see a demonstration that Lenire was clinically superior to treatment with sound-only stimulation in order for them to grant it FDA approval. The TENT A3 study, which was conducted from March to October in 2022, involved 112 participants across three sites in Belgium, Germany, and Ireland. It was meticulously designed with guidance from the FDA, and participants underwent two treatment stages. The first 6 weeks involved sound-only stimulation, and then they were exposed to 6 weeks of treatment with Lenire using a combination of sound and tongue stimulation. Now, in order to get FDA approval, Lenire had to demonstrate that the latter 6 weeks outperformed the benefits received from the sound-only half of the study. From my understanding, the primary goal of the trial was to assess the responder rate, defined as a participant achieving at least a 7-point improvement in their tinnitus handicap inventory score, which is a subjective questionnaire used around the world to assess the effect that tinnitus has on a patient's quality of life. And this is where it gets very interesting. In total, 58.6% of these participants saw a clinically significant improvement in their THI scores during the bimodal treatment phase, which is remarkable across a six-week clinical trial compared to only 43.2% during the sound-only phase. Moreover, 70.5% of participants who didn't see an improvement with sound-only therapy reported meaningful benefits after 6 weeks of bimodal treatment. And as a result, there were incredibly high levels of patient satisfaction reported. Specifically, 88.6% of the participants indicated that they would recommend this device to others, demonstrating high user satisfaction and perceived benefit, which is, in fact, a big deal. So my key take-home messages are for those participants with moderate to severe tinnitus, the majority responded positively to bimodal treatment versus sound-only treatment. And 79.4% of the full cohort showed an improvement over the full 12-week program. If you're interested in the finer details, I'll link the full study in the description to today's video. Secondly, you may well be thinking, all right, well, this sounds fantastic, but is it actually safe zapping myself in the face with electricity? And I think it's a fair question to ask. I've asked the same thing, as did the FDA. And they had some potential questions around safety and the dangers and any side effects too. You'll be pleased to know that all roads led positively around health and safety. And during their studies, Lenire has also been proven to be inherently safe with zero serious side effects across all of their clinical trials. Now, my job is to give you all of the detail today and not skim over anything. So that's not to say with what I've just said that there weren't any side effects whatsoever. So I should make you aware that there were some reports of slight increases in tinnitus or glossodyna, which did, however, resolve without any need for intervention. And my third and final positive before I come onto the areas of development is the high level of treatment compliance that they also reported too. You see, unless the equipment is easy to use and the time commitment is achievable, this tinnitus treatment wouldn't be good for anybody. This new TENT-A3 study demonstrated that participants showed high compliance rates with the treatment protocol, with 82.4% adhering to the prescribed usage of the device. In my opinion, therefore, there is no question that the ease of use and the home-based nature of this treatment positively contributed to this high level of compliance. Bearing in mind, this is also just the beginning. Now, I don't want to get carried away, but whilst the TENT-A3 study focused on those with a mild to severe tinnitus, I feel that this device's bimodal stimulation approach could potentially be applicable across different tinnitus profiles too going forwards. So let's watch this space. This versatility makes me think that Lenire has the potential for a wider range of tinnitus sufferers down the line, including those that may not respond well to traditional methods. So watch this space for further developments within this area. The evidence that Lenire have provided to receive this FDA clearance is compelling, and there are a lot of tinnitus sufferers out there that have already benefited from it. You can find this all online. At the same time, my scientific brain has been working on overdrive, thinking of areas that I believe Neuromod should continue to focus their attention on to make their research a little more credible. So, as promised, here are three areas of the study that I wanted to highlight for you guys watching today from Neuromod's research. I would also love to hear your thoughts around the research too, so let me know what you think within the comments beneath this video. And while you're at it, of course, I would 100% recommend subscribing to the Hearing Tracker YouTube channel to be notified whenever I release any new videos on up and coming tinnitus treatments. Lenire's TENT-A3 clinical trial was a multi-site, single-arm controlled clinical trial. And as I mentioned earlier, Lenire treats tinnitus through supra-threshold stimulation, which can be easily detected by a patient. In Lenire's case, patients can hear the audio and feel that tongue stimulation. Some would argue, and myself included, that the gold standard in terms of studies would be to do a double-blinded setup, with neither the participant nor the researcher knowing if they were receiving the treatment or if they were receiving a placebo. The challenge with this, however, is that because both sound and tongue stimuli are supra-threshold, how many times to record this, i.e. they can be heard and felt, it's pretty tough to apply a placebo. Whilst double-blinding can reduce researcher and participant bias, patients can notice if they're not experiencing a stimulation. And as a result, a placebo isn't always a practical clinical trial methodology for many clinical studies. Whilst Lenire have done the best that they could around the circumstances for this particular study, looking at both the long and short-term effectiveness of it, perhaps maybe when we see some future research, I'd like to see the implementation of what we call a sham control. Now, this could be an acoustic stimulation, which is similar but not the exact therapy of the one being tested, or perhaps they could even use a low-intensity tactile stimulation that's perceptible but not therapeutic. And this would maybe increase the credibility of any further studies going forwards. Secondly, Lenire's previous TENT A1 and TENT A2 studies demonstrated that Lenire can provide long-term relief from tinnitus that's sustained for at least 12 months. Now, I think that it would be fascinating to see a study with a follow-up period over a period of several years to further test the durability of Lenire's benefits. Thinking about it, maybe one of the reasons that this isn't possible is that the tech hasn't been around for long enough to be able to see that level of benefit. So, my suggestion, if there's anybody from Neuromod watching this today, is I would love to see that included in your research going forwards. As part of Lenire's de novo FDA approval grant, Neuromod was required to demonstrate that Lenire's bimodal neuromodulation could outperform currently accepted tinnitus treatment methods. In this case, it was done against sound-only therapy. Now, in my opinion, it makes sense that Lenire focused on one standard care, as clinical trials involving multiple tinnitus treatments, such as the Widex-Zen therapy program, concluded that comparisons with a combination of different tinnitus treatment therapies can be effective, but it's difficult to ascertain which individual therapy is contributing to the benefits. Having successfully achieved this with the TENT A3 study, I would like to see further research from Lenire around other treatments too, as well as sound enrichment therapy. Now, whilst I can fully appreciate why using sound stimulation only as a control group would be a great place to start, I also think that there's such a big potential for comparing Lenire with the effectiveness of other tinnitus treatments too. And this would provide us with more insight into the relative effectiveness of Lenire on a broader scale. Now, before you go and visit a tinnitus specialist, there are some basic lifestyle changes that you can make to overcome your tinnitus, which I've outlined in this video that has almost 500,000 views. Watch it now.